Science Academy, the science provider of the nation.
We're going to study about speed and velocity. So, the speed is a typical word what we use in our day-to-day life. Whenever you travel in a vehicle, you say to your father, go speeder, go faster. That is a very typical word what we use. But sometimes the term velocity is new for you all. However, speed and velocity are two quantities to measure how quick an object is moving.
So consider the above scenario out of object 1 and 2. Object 1 moves quicker than object 2. It shows that the speed of object 1 is higher than object 2. Basically, speed means how quicker a movement happens. We define speed as the distance traversed in a unit time. The standard international unit of speed is meter per second. The equation for speed is speed is equal to distance over time taken. Speed is a scalar quantity.
So whenever you get the term unit time, it means 1 second. I mean, how much distance an object traveled in 1 second. What is unit time means? What this speed is simply can be defined as how much an object moved or travel in a unit time. So distance can be defined, can be measured or calculated by below equation that you studied about distance. Distance divided by the time taken. Speed is equal to distance divided by the time taken. So as you all know, we measure the distance in meters and time we measure in second. Therefore, the unit will be, whenever this second goes up, the unit will be meter per second. The unit will be meters per second. So, speed is a scalar quantity which has no direction. As usual, distance have no direction. Therefore, speed have no direction. Okay, so very simply, measured in meter second minus 1. So, usually speed, we label it as U. Speed, label it as U. Distance, S. And time taken, T. So, S over T is U. But if you consider about an object, whenever it moves, it will have different speeds in each and every second. It changes for every second. For example, when I move from here to there, I will not have a constant speed. What happens is, whenever I move, the speed varies for each and every second. But it is not possible to calculate that exact value. Therefore, what we do is, we use to calculate whatever the speed we are measuring. Even the speed what we measure in vehicle is not the exact speed at every second. It varies. What we usually, typically calculate is the mean speed or the average speed. So, we need average speed. Total distance traveled divided by time taken. This is the equation for the average speed. Usually in our physics, what we measure is the average speed or a mean speed. However, there are two equations. The first exact equation for speed is none other than distance divided by time taken, but for average speed, it is total distance traveled divided by total time taken. Constant speed. A constant speed or uniform speed term constant means not changing, uniform means exact. So a constant speed is a speed which will never vary. It will be the same value for the entire motion. If it is 3ms minus 1, entire it will be 3ms minus 1. A uniform or a constant speed means it is not changing. It is a fixed value. That is, we call a constant speed. One is velocity. Velocity means the rate of change of displacement. Whenever you find the rate, what you are finding is for 1 second, is for 1 unit, what is the change. So displacement and distance are two different things. However, displacement divided by time taken is the equation for velocity. So velocity is equal to displacement divided by time taken. Velocity is equal to displacement divided by time taken. So displacement is measured in meters and time taken is measured in second. Displacement is measured in meters, time taken is measured in second. Therefore the unit is meter second minus 1, which is the same unit of speed. But there is a difference between velocity and speed. Speed is a scalar quantity, but velocity is a vector quantity. The reason, displacement is a vector quantity. So therefore, velocity is measured in meter second minus 1, but it is a vector quantity. Again, the mean velocity means the total displacement divided by the total time taken, because each and every second the velocity varies. The equation for mean velocity is equal to total displacement over time taken. The unit is meter second minus 1, and even the mean velocity is a vector quantity. What is a constant uniform velocity? A uniform velocity is a not varying velocity. Here, not only the magnitude but also the direction of velocity will not change. Because we all know that velocity is a vector quantity. If I say 3 meter second minus 1, right side, this velocity and 3 meter second minus 1, left side, are not equal. These two are equal in magnitude, but they are not equal in direction. So whenever you consider about a uniform velocity is the velocity which is constant in magnitude as well in direction. So two of them should be the same value. Uniform velocity is a velocity which has the same magnitude and the same direction, or a constant not changing direction and the magnitude. We call it the mean, so the uniform velocity. Let's do this example. Ravi moves from A to B. Okay, the typical person, the typical term, what we get? Okay, Ravi moves from A to B. So Ravi uses this path, that is his path. So you know, whenever we move from a place to another, it will not be a straight line. It used to be a curvy going that side, this side. So, however, mostly we use the distance. That means the distance and displacement, they will never be equal, as due to the physical environment. They will be different. Because whenever we move from our school to our home to school, we can't go straight. Because there will be mountain, building, everything, we have to go curvy. So however, Ravi is moving from A to B. This is his path. And the distance and the length of his path is 400 meters. So Ravi takes about 100 seconds. Ravi takes 100 seconds to move from A to B. So the first part, the first question, find the distance. Find the distance. So what is the distance? And that 400 meter. So the direction is upward. It is north. The upward is north. Okay. What is the displacement? Next one is, what is the displacement? The displacement is the shortest length or the straight line from A to B is how much? It is 200 meter. And then, what is the time taken? So time taken is 100 seconds. Now if I ask you, time taken is 100 seconds. If I ask you, what is the speed? If I ask you, what is the speed of Ravi? So here, you should think, Ravi start from A and B, his distance is 400. So you all know that speed is given by distance divided by time taken. So how much the distance? 400 meter divided by time taken, it is 100 second. So the value will be 4 meter second minus 1. Is there any importance or any purpose mandatory to mention the direction? It is not compulsory because it's a scalar quantity. So speed is 4 meter second minus 1. Finally, I am coming to the final point to find you the velocity. What will be the velocity? So simply, the velocity will be displacement divided by time taken. So what is the displacement of Ravi? 400 to 200 is 200. So 200 divided by time taken, the same time will be taken. So 100 second will be 2 meter second minus 1. So simple. But here, I need to mention the direction. 2 meter second minus 1, what is the direction? It should be east. This is the most important thing, what you should know under this part. So let's do another question. Let's come to another question. So here, this is the map of Kumar's house and bus stop at the school. So here from Kumar's house to bus stop, it is 1000 meters. And from bus stop to school, it is 4 kilometers. Right. So what is Kumar's daily routine? What he usually do is, he used to walk from his house to bus stop. So it takes 10 minutes to move this 1000 meter. And then from bus stop, he takes a bus and move to school. It is about 4 kilometers in distance. And it takes 10 minutes. So in bus, 4 kilometers, 10 minutes. And here walking, 1000 meter, 10 minutes. So the shortest length, whenever it is the straight line, it will be about 4.2 kilometer. Right. So here, this is daily routine. So what is happening is, so the first question, so everything here is not in a specific or considered unit. So whenever you do questions, you should think on a very thing, an important thing, to make everything to the SI standard, SI format. Standard international format. So if 4 kilometer means 4000 meter, 10 minutes means it is 600 seconds, because we measure in seconds. Here also 600 second, 4.2 kilometer means it is 4200 meters. So what's happening is, Kumar daily moves from house to bus stop and from bus stop to school. That is his routine. So if I ask you, what is the distance? So here he is moving with two speeds, two different speeds, because the initial he is walking, it is less speed, and in bus it is more speed than that, high speed, because he is trying 4 km in 10 minutes, here just 1 km of 1000 meter in 10 minutes. So the speeds are varying. So what I am going to do is, first question, I am asking you the distance from house to school. What is it? 1000, 4000, 5000 meter. The first question, what is the distance from house to school? It is 5000 meter. Second, I am asking, what is the displacement from house to school? What is the displacement? It is 4200 meter. Easy, the shortest length. Third, I ask you, what is the speed from house to bus stop? What is the speed he is traveling from house to bus stop? So you know that the distance from house to bus stop, so speed is given by distance divided by time taken. It is 1000 meter divided by 600 meter. So the answer will be 10 divided by 6 or 5 divided by 3, about 1.6 meters second minus 1. So the speed from house to bus stop is 1.6 meters second minus 1. Secondly, the speed from bus stop to school, how much it will be? The speed from bus stop to school. So we all know that bus stop to school speed is equal to distance over time taken. Distance is 4000, time taken is 600 seconds. So if you divide it, the value will be 4 divided by 6, 20 divided by 3, 6.6 meters second minus 1. So there are two different speeds. The next question, if they ask you what is the mean speed or the average speed, because the issue, there are two different speeds. The initial speed is less and the second speed is 1.6 and here it is 6.6. So the average speed can be given. Average speed can be given total distance over total time taken. So what is the total distance? 5000 divided by what is the time taken? Total time, sorry, 5000. 1000 plus 4000, 5000. And the time taken is totally how much? 1200 second. So here the value will be 00 get shock, 25 divided by 6. So it will be about 4.18 or something. So it will be about 4.1 meter second minus 1. This is the average speed of Kumar's movement. Right, the next one. If I ask you what is the average velocity, this value is changed. The average velocity is the total displacement divided by the total time taken. It is none other than 4200 divided by total time taken is 1200. Therefore the answer will be 42 divided by 12, 21 divided by 6, the answer 3.5. So that is the 3.5 meter second minus 1. But here you should narrate the direction. 3.5 meter second minus 1. The direction. So let's say if it is north, it is look like southeast. Southeast in direction. So this is another example what can be in your exams. The next part what we are going to study is about acceleration. Acceleration means the rate of change of velocity. We define it the rate of change of velocity. So we studied what is velocity. So here the acceleration means the rate how much the velocity is changing. For example, what is acceleration? Acceleration is the change of rate of velocity. So, the change of rate of velocity means how much the velocity changing is happening in a unit time. For example, if I take, so the equation, we define the acceleration as the rate of change of velocity. The equation is acceleration is equal to change of velocity divided by time taken. Change of velocity divided by time taken. If anyone asks you a change, it is the final minus initial. For example, if anyone asks my change in weight, the final weight of my and the initial weight of my, I should subtract the initial from the final. There I get the change. So here the change of velocity means it is final velocity divided by, subtracted initial velocity. That is the change of velocity and the time taken for this change. So we know that whenever you get the change in velocity, it will be in meter second minus 1. And the time taken we measure in second, therefore the unit of acceleration will be meter second minus 2, that is meter per second, how we pronounce it. So this is the unit of standard international unit of acceleration. Acceleration is a vector quantity as velocity is a vector quantity. So acceleration is a velocity vector quantity, is the change of rate of velocity, can be derived from change of velocity divided by the time taken. Let's do one example. So there is an object, there is a car. It is at rest. Rest means it is not moving. The velocity is 0 meter second minus 1. And within 5 seconds, so you started the car, within 5 seconds, you reach a velocity. You reach a velocity of, so at, it is 0 meter second, after 5 seconds, you reach a velocity of 5 meter second, or I will say 10 meter second minus 1. So this is the initial velocity. Initially it was 0 meter second minus 1. And finally it is 10 meter second minus 1. If I ask you to find the rate of change of velocity, that is the acceleration, acceleration is equal to, so usually we will mark the final velocity as v and the initial velocity as u. It is v minus u divided by the time taken. So time taken is 5 seconds. So here v is 10 and u is 0, the initial velocity is 0. And time taken is 5. So meter second minus 1 second, the answer should be 2 meter per second per second. So 2 meter second minus 2 is the first example. Here the velocity is increasing, therefore, so after time the velocity is increasing, therefore the answer what we got is in positive. Let's look after a negative change of velocity. For example, let's say there is a vehicle which moves with a velocity of 5 meter second minus 1. Which moves with a velocity of 5 meter second 1. All of a sudden, it applied the brake. It applied the brake and it came to rest. Rest means it is not moving. It came to rest. It is not moving. So it came to rest, the velocity becomes 0 meter second minus 1. Why? The velocity is stopped, it is stuck. Okay? To stop this motion, it took about 4 seconds. Let's consider it took about 4 seconds. So this is the initial velocity and this is the final velocity. So this is the initial velocity, u, and this is the final velocity. So we usually mark initial velocity in the term, in the letter u, and the final velocity in v, right? And the time taken was 4 seconds. If anyone asks what is the acceleration of the motion, here the answer should be acceleration is equal to final velocity minus initial velocity. That is the change of velocity. Okay, the final velocity, initial, then the change. Finally how much it is and initially how much it is. This is change. So final velocity minus initial velocity divided by the time taken. Here the time taken is 4 seconds. So v is 0 and u is 5 meter second minus 1. Divided by time taken, it is 4. So 0 minus 5 is minus 5 meter second minus 1 divided by 4 seconds. So the answer will be minus 1.25 meter second minus 2, because the second goes up. So here the acceleration is a negative value. The negative acceleration is known as deceleration. The negative acceleration is known as deceleration. deceleration means the velocity is reducing. The velocity is reducing. So, if they ask you what is the deceleration of this motion, so if they ask you the acceleration, they ask you what is the acceleration, the answer should be minus 1.25 meter second minus 2. But if they ask you the deceleration, this minus no need to, because if it is d, the term d is there, therefore no need to put this minus, the answer should be 1.25 meter second minus 2. Simple. Right. The next question what we are going to study is about VT and ST graph. Here guys, what you should know is you should study be thorough in the portion of graph. We have uploaded a lecture on linear graph. Please refer it and be prepared and be thorough in graph. You should be capable to identify the gradient. You should be capable to identify a coordinate, and you should be capable to identify a covered area of a graph. So first you should know what is y-axis, x-axis, intercept and the gradient, and how to calculate them, and how the positive gradient will be, how the negative gradient will be. Please refer the lecture and be prepared. We will be studying about ST and VT graph, that the displacement time graph and the velocity time graph, in the upcoming lecture. That in that lecture we will be capable to catch the entire program, entire unit of motion in straight line. So I'll expect, the link is below of this video. Please go and refer the video and be prepared to the next lesson.
Science Academy, the science provider of the nation.